Hello students, today we are going to learn about the data normality. There are actually different stages in data analysis using statistics, especially in SPSS. Basically there are two parts of statistics. One is descriptive statistics and other is inferential statistics. In descriptive statistics we have to describe the data normality, data reliability, data validity, and data normality can be checked through different techniques like skewness and kurtosis, PP plots, QQ plots, Jorg-Behr test, Shapiro-Wilk test, KS test, Kolmogorov-Smirnov test, and there are other different things we can use in different softwares. And data normality, in this case today we are going to learn it through skewness and kurtosis. There are different authors, they have given the cutoff level for skewness and kurtosis. According to Julia Palin 2010, the value of skewness and kurtosis should be between minus 1 plus 1 or minus 2 plus 2. And according to Andy Field 2013 in his book Discovering Statistics Using SPSS, he has mentioned that if the sample size is 100, then the value of skewness and kurtosis should be between minus and plus 1.96. If the sample size is 200 or more, then the data the value of skewness and kurtosis should be between minus 2.58 and plus 2.58. But if the sample size is more than 300, then the value of skewness and kurtosis should be between plus 3 and 3.29 and minus 3.29. So today I am going to teach you how to get the data normal. First we have to make our mind clear that why we get our data normal. So when we use parametric test like correlation, regression or ANOVA t-test, so these are very powerful tools. So for these tools data should be normal. If the data is not normal, then it will change the inferences of our results, test or our data. So our data should be normal. So today we are going to use IDF, inverse distribution function, to get our data normal. First we will check the data and I will show you that whether our data is normal or not. Then we have to run the whole process how to get normal, how to get data normal through skewness and kurtosis using inverse distribution function. So first we have to go to analyze, and you can see descriptive statistics and frequencies. You can get skewness and kurtosis through frequencies and descriptives, but I will use the frequencies. I reset it. So first these are the items. You can bring 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 100 items, but first today I am going to use one item. Okay, click here and bring it to variable box, go to statistics, click on mean, standard deviation, skewness and kurtosis, and click continue, and click on charts, histogram, show normal curve, continue, we don't need frequency tables, and click OK. If you see, we get the mean and standard deviation, skewness is minus 0.798, standard error of skewness is 0.18, standard error of kurtosis is 0.358. One thing I want to clear that the standard error of skewness and standard error of kurtosis will remain same for every item, that is 0.180, but the value of skewness and kurtosis will be changed for every item. So we have, if you see the value minus 0.798 and 1.14, it seems or it looks like the data is in the range of plus minus 1.96, plus minus 2.58 or plus minus 3.29, but actually we have to get the z-score, and for z-score we have to use calculator, and we have to divide the value of skewness minus 0.798 divided by standard error of skewness 0.180. And you can see that the value is more than plus minus 3.29, the cutoff level given by Andy Field, minus 4.43. If you check the kurtosis value, that is 1.141 divided by 0.358, and it is also in the range of 3.18, but we have to bring the value of skewness into the range. So we have to use the inverse distribution function. For inverse distribution function, you have to go to transform. First click on rank cases and bring the question A1 into the reset it, and bring question 1 into variable box. Go to rank types and click on fraction rank. We don't need rank. Continue and OK. If you go to your data set, a new variable is formed like RFR001. If you want to normalize your 100 items, then it will RF002, RF003, and so on. So you have to go to transform again, click on compute variable and reset it. Okay, if you see on the right hand side, there is a function group, and we need inverse distribution function, inverse df. When you click on inverse df, the list of formulas will appear here. Inverse distribution. Now the list is appear. We have to click on the IDF normal. Remember, we don't need IDF L normal. We need IDF normal. Click here. The formula will go there, and from this box we have to bring the formula here upside. Oh, upside. Sorry. Okay, we have to fill these three question marks. We have to bring the new item fractional rank RF001 here, and we have to write the mean here. If you remember, we have taken the mean of first item. The mean of first item is 4.0110. 4.0110, and we have to write the standard deviation. Remember, don't remove the commas in these brackets. The standard deviation is 0.72819. Okay, new name, new question A11. Okay, and click OK. Okay, if you go to your data set, you see new question arises here. Okay, we don't need this one. Now clear it and go to analyze again, descriptive frequencies, and bring your new item in the variable box. Here, okay, keep it here. We have to see the difference between these two items, whether I want to show whether our new item is normal or not. Click OK. You see the skewness value of old item is 0.7898 and new item is 0.239. It is reduced, and the kurtosis value of old item is 1.141 and new item is 0.058. So we have to use calculator, and we have to divide the these values and get z score -0.239 divided by 0.180. Enter. The value is -1.327. It is normal now, which is in the range of ±1.96, ±2.58, and ±3.29. And now 0.058 divided by 0.358. Enter. 0.16. It is also in the range. So we can see. We can also see the histogram. The histogram for old item, you can see the peakness of the bell shape bell curve is high, but if you see the peakness of the new normal item is low, or you can see it's less high than the previous one. So you can use this inverse distribution function to get your data normal, and if you have more than 10 question items, 20 items, or up to 100 items, you can use this process on the whole of your data set, on the whole of your questionnaire, or your items, and then you can get your data normal. And after that, you can see our next video, how to get data reliability and how to get data valid through exploratory factor analysis. Thank you for watching.